Acne is the most common skin condition that affects 10% of the world. And while there may be different reasons that acne occurs on the body, including sebum and keratin production, acne-causing bacteria, hormones, and inflammation, there's one cause that seems to be controversial, and that is your diet. The diet-acne connection was considered a myth at one point. Now there's some research revisiting this conversation that seems compelling. In this video, we will look at four types of foods that cause acne, as well as one trace mineral in your diet that could beat acne altogether. If you guys are new here, my channel is all about helping you make informed decisions about your health and wellness, and I would love for you all to gently tap on the like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Also, if you're on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get started. The first on the list is your high glycemic foods, or what I like to call your movie theater foods. Popcorn, pretzels, and candy, sugary drinks. These can all contribute to acne vulgaris. And the reason why is not too complicated to follow. This study titled Significance of Diet in Treated and Untreated Acne Vulgaris shows us diet based on products with a high glycemic index leads to hyperinsulinemia, which is your elevated insulin levels that stimulate the secretion of androgens and cause an increased production of sebum, which plays a fundamental role in the pathogenesis of acne vulgaris. We also know that having high insulin also affects the levels of circulating IGF-1, which stands for insulin-like growth factor 1, which directly affects how your keratinocytes proliferate. More on that in a second. Fruits can have a high glycemic index as well. These include watermelon, pineapple, papaya, and the highest of them all, dates. So if you're eating any of these, start to pay attention to how it affects your skin, because I know glycemic index and load are different, which we can discuss at a later video. Interestingly though, cherries have a low load. And I know you might be thinking, that's not enough to go off of. Show me a study where low glycemic index foods helped acne, then I would be more convinced. Well, this randomized control trial looked at just that. 43 males aged 15 to 25 were recruited for 12 weeks. It concluded that the improvement in acne and insulin sensitivity after a low glycemic load diet suggests that nutrition-related lifestyle factors may play a role in the pathogenesis of acne. So it really is interesting how that plays out. The second is, I'm sure you guessed it, which is dairy, milk, and dairy products. Remember how we mentioned insulin-like growth factor 1 from earlier? How high glycemic foods raises those levels? Well, this study from earlier also mentions how it stimulates 5-alpha reductase in adrenal glands and gonads, and androgen synthesis, the androgen receptor signal transduction, sebaceous proliferation, and lipogenesis, with the highest concentrations of IGF-1 to be found in women with acne, and the number of acne lesions positively correlates with the plasma levels of IGF-1. High plasma levels of IGF-1, which are caused by consumption of milk, stimulates proliferation of sebaceous, resulting in the development and progression of acne lesions. And remember, IGF-1 is also high during puberty, which is a time where acne is more likely anyway. The third food to cause acne is fast food. And fast food is a staple upon Western diets. Anything from burgers, nuggets, hot dogs, french fries, sodas, milkshakes. Turns out they can potentially affect gene expression and alter hormone levels mediated by the forkhead box transcription factor 01 and mTORC1. According to this study, and it's not only of critical importance to understand the impact of the Western diet on the promotion of epidemic acne, but more seriously, mTORC1-driven diseases of civilization. So the harmful effects are not just confined to just acne. Cardiovascular disease is a big problem in the US, and diet is one of the first places you should assess. So again, it's something you're going to have to pay attention to. Are you breaking out after going through your favorite drive-thrus? Start paying attention to the fast foods you eat and the acne you experience, whether that's on the face, neck, shoulders, or back. And now you might be wondering, what was the trace element that you mentioned earlier that could help acne? Well, In early studies of the influence of zinc on human skin conducted by Michelson and Fitzherbert in the 1970s, it has been shown that acne improved with oral zinc supplementation in zinc deficient patients. Later studies have confirmed that patients with acne often are deficient in zinc, and this oral supplementation has a positive effect on treatments of acne vulgaris. Now, chances are you might already be getting enough zinc in your diet if you're in the US, but it's always great to have these measured. If you're from places like India or Africa, you can be more vulnerable to a zinc deficiency. So make sure to talk to your doctor to check in for these values. In the meantime, if you're looking for products, I left my best recommendation for treating acne down below, as well as a zinc-infused facial soap that I think could help as well. And even though there are some strong studies, no meta-analysis or well-designed scientific trials that give you hard guidelines that tell you what to eat and what not to eat for acne exist, the best recommendation I can give you is to enjoy your favorite foods in moderation. And if you find that some of them make your skin worse, try cutting them out to see if it helps. Curious to see if there was anything I missed or if you know of anything that helps. Leave them down below, and in the meantime, click that subscribe button if you found any value in this video, and I'll see you on the next one.